तो वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू, जय हिंद एंड वेलकम टू राज लोथरस आईएएस एंड टू द लीग अफेयर्स एंड ग्रेट ग्रेट. सो एज वी कैन सी दैट पीपल हैव जॉइंड एंड वी आर गुड टू गो, वी आर कनेक्टेड. लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड विद द फर्स्ट आर्टिकल दैट वी आर डिस्कसिंग दैट कंसर्न्स द फॉरेन डायरेक्ट इन्वेस्टमेंट इन द स्टेट ऑफ कर्नाटका. कर्नाटका हैज स्टॉप्ड इट अगेन इन द प्रीवियस फाइनेंशियल ईयर, दैट इज रिसीविंग मैक्सिमम नंबर ऑफ एफडीआईज, राइट. So that is the article we are going to talk about, and we are going to look at a couple of questions as well. So apart from that, what is in news is the National Startup Day, that is the 16th of January has been declared to be observed as the National Startup Day, right? So on that count also, why we are discussing National Startup Day, remember National Startup Day or the startups which we are talking about here, that has also been one of the major reasons that, you know, has been that Karnataka government has been instrumental, has played an instrumental role as far as the startup ecosystem, the startup industry in their state is concerned. They have given support to them, and that is why they are leading in terms of attracting the maximum number of foreign investments, be it capital I, be it FDI, right? Exactly. So let's move to the discussion. This another article talks about India's first National Startup Day, that is also going to be discussed, right? So what becomes important from your prelims perspective is basically the foreign portfolio investment, foreign direct investment, what are the rankings of different states, and certainly why Karnataka has been able to be at the top, right? Shubhankar is saying there is a sound problem. Is it the same thing which anybody else is also experiencing? Let me just readjust the mic's position. Yes, is it clear now? Please confirm it to me in the comment section. Sound clear hai na? Sound mein koi issue to nahi hai, because I just read a couple of comments asking about the no disturbance. Theek hai. Some people are saying that there is no issue, so I believe that we are good to go. Okay, not clear. You are saying it is not clear. Still, you are saying that it is not clear. Just wait for a second. I'll just try and readjust the position of the mic. Is it clear now? I'll hold the mic in my hand itself. Still, is it a problem? If still that is a problem, then ab theek hai. Okay, great. Shubhankar is saying that it is fine now. So I'll just do one thing. I'll hold it in my hand itself. And bear with me. Yeah, maybe the mic is having problem. Right. Chalo, theek hai. So bear with me. I'll hold the mic in my hand itself. Theek hai. Great. So look, what is important from prelims perspective is that the foreign portfolio investment, foreign direct investment, FIIs, right, FDIs, and how exactly was Karnataka able to manage its top position vis-a-vis attracting the maximum amount of foreign investment. Right. So Karnataka has, you know, it has been able to attract more than 50% of the total investment received in the entire country. On top of that, it was the state of Karnataka that was able to attract that investment, right? And that is why we are talking about the case of startups here also. That the startup industry, or for any entrepreneur who is beginning their business, right? In the state of Karnataka, the state government is providing tremendous amount of support to them. They are actually hand-holding them. They are letting them, you know, grow. And that support has led to Karnataka maintain its edge over all the other parts of the country, all the other major states of the country, including Maharashtra, which has Mumbai, which is the financial capital. Right. So that is certainly a golden feather in the Karnataka's hat. Then when we talk about the startups, so that is linked with the Karnataka article itself, but apart from that, recently the Prime Minister declared January 16 to be observed as the National Startups Day, right? And to promote this culture of startup in other parts of the country, look, Karnataka has been one successful example. Karnataka has been a successful example as far as, you know, they have shown that yes, the startups, if they have the potential and if they have the requisite support from the government, then they can certainly shine very brightly. So that needs to be taken to other parts of the country also, and for that we are trying to give this impetus through observing the National Startup Day, right? So there were measures also now which must be discussed. which the government has already taken to promote the startups. For example, the Startup India program. Then angel tax related issues, they have been sorted by the government in the previous budgets. Apart from that, simplification of tax procedure. Then arranging for government funding, allowing self-certification in more than, you know, nine labor laws and 3 environmental laws. So that all provides a sense of ease of doing business to the startups in the country. Right. So that is with respect to this article. Right. So let's take a question now. Hanji. Which of the following statements is or are correct? First, that is, to promote technological innovation in Karnataka, the state government will give seed funding of up to rupees 50 lakh each in the current financial year to the startups. And second, an artificial intelligence and robotics translational park is being set up at IISc, Indian Institute of Sciences, Bengaluru, which will help Karnataka maintain its edge in the sector of technology. Yes, so what do you think should be the answer here? Okay, Rohit is saying C. Yes, exactly. Rook. Great, exactly. You know, the state of Karnataka we are talking about, so they have, you know, decided to provide 50 lakh each in the current financial year to the startups. So all certain conditions are already, you know, they are also attached with it. But yes, that is going to give a boost to the startup ecosystem. And through that, they are also going to excel in the innovation front. And remember, wherever there is innovation involved, that is certainly going to give boost to your industry and maybe also lead you to attract foreign investments. Right. So first statement is correct. Then the second statement, that an artificial intelligence and robotics park is being set up at IISc Bengaluru. Yes, that is also true. That has been declared by the government of Karnataka. It is in the process of being set up. So answer will be both 1 and 2. Question 1, answer will be C. Right. Chaliye. So let's move to another question now. Hanji. Another question based on the same concept. That is, which of the following statements is or are correct with respect to startups in India? First, as a success for the Startup India program, more than 100 startups turned unicorns during the financial year 2020-2021. Second statement, the government has given exemption to startups under the Income Tax Act in cases where the total investment, including funding from angel investors, did not exceed rupees 10 crore. And third, for this exemption, startups are required to get approval from an interministerial board and a certificate of valuation by a merchant banker. So that is regarding the startups. This question pertains to the startups. So please mark your answers. Yes. Okay, so we have some answers here. Vivek says, Rohit says B, and Chandrakant says B, Kavita says D. Right. So look, B and D, abhi tak jo answers I can take a look at. Right, so certainly, dekho, jo second or third statements, and they are linked with each other. Right, that to promote or to simplify the angel investments, the taxations have been, you know, tax has been made lenient as far as the startups are concerned. And that is why these provisions were made available for the startups to grow in the country. Right. So second and third are absolutely true. But as far as the first statement is concerned, that is incorrect. Why? Why is the first statement incorrect? Because in all you have roughly about, you can say, 84 unicorns in India. Now the question is, what is a unicorn? Yes, can anybody tell me this answer? What is a unicorn here? What exactly we mean by unicorn here? That we are writing that, you know, as a successful model. Yeah, somewhere 81 to 83, 84 unicorns we have in the country. But what exactly is a unicorn? That is my question. Look, when we talk about the business sector, yes, exactly, 31 have been added. So any company that has reached a valuation of 1 billion, that is termed as a unicorn. So for that, India certainly has not crossed the 100 mark. We are still languishing below 50, right? In terms of the newly added ones, and total we are still languishing below 100. Yeah, exactly. Right. Exactly. So that is where India is still lacking. We do not have that amount of unicorns in the country. ठीक है, but this number 100 is going to be crossed soon if we are going to provide the right amount of policy environment, the right kind of policy environment and the right kind of support in terms of taxation, in terms of ease of doing business. So for question number two, what is going to be the answer? Two and three, that is option B. Right. चलिए, ग्रेट. सो आई बिलीव दैट इज क्लियर. राइट, सो दैट वी हैव एडेड 42 स्टार्टअप्स टर्न्ड यूनिकॉर्न्स लास्ट ईयर. दैट इज व्हाट वाज हाइलाइटेड बाय द प्राइम मिनिस्टर. एंड राइट नाउ वी हैव समवेयर 82 टू 83 यूनिकॉर्न्स. राइट, सो दैट इज द केस एट प्रेजेंट. चलिए, मूविंग टू द नेक्स्ट आर्टिकल. नाउ दिस कंसर्न्स द बिल दैट वाज इंट्रोड्यूस्ड इन द पार्लियामेंट. द बिल दैट वाज इंट्रोड्यूस्ड इन द पार्लियामेंट कंसर्निंग द क्रिप्टो करेंसीज. Right, so what exactly is the case with cryptocurrencies? Let's discuss that. Sound problem. Okay, again, is the voice again getting broken? Yes, I think it should be clear now. I don't think that the sound should be an issue. Yeah, Shubhankar is saying no problem. चलो, ग्रेट ग्रेट ग्रेट. आई हैव टू यू नो मेक सम अरेंजमेंट फॉर दिस माइक बिकॉज इट इज टर्निंग. ठीक है ठीक है ठीक है, चलिए ग्रेट. सो लेट्स कंटिन्यू. तो ये आर्टिकल जो है दिस टॉक्स अबाउट यू नो द राइट नाउ द पार्लियामेंट द क्रिप्टो करेंसी रेगुलेशन एंड ऑफिशियल डिजिटल करेंसी बिल 2021 दैट वॉज टेबल्ड इन द पार्लियामेंट. राइट, एंड द स्टांस टेकन बाय द रिजर्व बैंक ऑफ इंडिया दैट इज द सेंट्रल बैंक. So you have the this bill being introduced in the parliament, which still is not passed. Remember, it is only in the stage of a bill, and that is going to concern how the cryptocurrencies are going to be regulated in the country. Right now, they certainly, अभी तक जो है, Reserve Bank of India ने कोई भी official backing, the RBI has not given any kind of backing to the cryptocurrencies in the India. इनको अभी तक कोई भी लीगल टेंडर की बैकिंग नहीं दी गई है बाय द रिजर्व बैंक ऑफ इंडिया. नीदर हैव दे बीन रिकॉग्नाइज्ड बाय द सेंट्रल बैंक ऑफ द कंट्री. ठीक है, बट द पॉइंट इज दैट स्टिल द पीपल दे आर मेकिंग इन्वेस्टमेंट्स एंड दैट इज व्हाई दे नीड टू बी रेगुलेटेड. क्रिप्टो करेंसीज को रेगुलेट करना इसीलिए जरूरी है क्योंकि ऑलरेडी जो लोग हैं वो इन्वेस्टमेंट्स कर रहे हैं इसमें. दे आर ऑलरेडी अर्निंग प्रॉफिट्स, दे आर मेकिंग प्रॉफिट्स बाय इन्वेस्टिंग इन द क्रिप्टो करेंसीज. और इसको अगर अनरेगुलेटेड छोड़ा जाए देन इट gives the you can say terror based outfits, it gives the anti-social elements a loophole where they can use it for money laundering, where they can use it for terror financing, where they can use it for a host of illegal activities. ठीक है, so that is why this is required कि आप एक bill के through provisions लेके आओ law में, देश के कानून को एक पक्का stance दो कि how you are going to regulate cryptocurrencies. Right, so that is why the absence of explicit tax provisions that has led to uncertainty and varied interpretations being adopted in relations to or in light of the tax provisions which are applicable to the cryptocurrencies. Right, aur isme sabse bada jo issue hai that is identity of the taxpayer who is transacting in cryptocurrencies that remains anonymous. Apart from that, lack of information on crypto transactions that also leads to difficulty in scrutinizing and identifying any kind of tax evasion. ठीक है, तो ये सारे issues जो हैं ये right now these are being sought to be addressed through this bill by the government which is in the parliament. Right, चलो, so let's move to the question now. Exactly the question on cryptocurrencies. हाँ जी, so consider the following statement vis-a-vis the cryptocurrencies. First, the Income Tax Act 1961 does not specifically mention cryptocurrencies, but it does cast a wide enough net to bring crypto transactions under its ambit. And second, trading in cryptocurrency may be classified as transfer of a capital asset taxable under the head capital gains. Yes, so what do you think should be the answer here? ओके राहुल सेज ए एंड रोहित आल्सो सेज ए, अहाना सेज सी. ठीक है देखो, एज फार एज द टैक्सेशन और टैक्स रिलेटेड प्रोविजंस आर कंसर्न्ड इन द इनकम टैक्स एक्ट राइट नाउ, सो सर्टेनली एक्सप्लिसिटली देयर इज नो प्रोविजन, और सेपरेटली there is no separate provision which concerns the cryptocurrencies in income tax act, lekin do teen provisions hain jiske under they can be you know taxed. First is certainly the capital gain which you have made with respect to any transaction that you made in the investment that was made by you in cryptocurrencies. Second is ek aur section hai, that is section 56 of the income tax act jo baat karta hai income from other sources. So this other sources certainly is undefined ki kisi individual ki kya other source ho sakti hai of income, right? So under that head also crypto transactions can be taxed, right? But this is true that specifically abhi tak koi bhi mentioning nahi hai income tax act mein cryptocurrencies ko leke, and that is where you require more clarity. You require more clarity on that count, on that front. Then second, that is trading in cryptocurrency. Isme capital gains wala provision invoke karke you can certainly tax it, right? So for question number 3, answer will be both 1 and 2. That is option C, right? Chaliye. So that is with respect to the Income Tax Act and the cryptocurrencies. और जो हम बात कर रहे थे दैट इज सेक्शन 56 जो बात करता है अदर सोर्सेज ऑफ इनकम ऑफ द इंडिविजुअल अंडर विच दिस क्रिप्टो करेंसी रिलेटेड इन्वेस्टमेंट्स कैन बी टैक्स्ड, राइट? चलिए ग्रेट, सो मूविंग टू द नेक्स्ट आर्टिकल. नाउ दिस इज द डीएलआई स्कीम फॉर विच द मेटी, द इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी मिनिस्ट्री, द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड इन्फॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी हैज सॉट एप्लीकेशंस. सो व्हाट बिकम्स इंपॉर्टेंट फ्रॉम एग्जाम पर्सपेक्टिव इज द डिजाइन लिंक्ड इंसेंटिव स्कीम and the semiconductor manufacturing in the country. Remember there is a shortage that was going on the semiconductor front, and because of that the automobile industry was facing severe shortage of semiconductor equipment, because of which there was a shortage in the manufacturing of automobiles also, right? So right now the MeitY has invited from the small and medium enterprises, from domestic companies, and also from the startups, that applications, if they want to come under the design linked incentive scheme and if they want to contribute to that, right? So they will be given the requisite support by the government. So the ministry has already approved 76,000 crore for the scheme to promote domestic manufacturing of semiconductor and allied devices. Now you see, when it comes to China, then certainly our dependence here is great, that with respect to or vis-a-vis the Chinese imports of semiconductors or the semiconductors which we import from China, that is certainly also one angle in the mind of the government, where while we are trying to promote the domestic production or the domestic manufacturing, you can say, right? So it is also going to reduce our reliance on the foreign players, especially the Chinese, and apart from that it is also going to give a boost to the Atmanirbhar Bharat, right? The self-reliance aspect. Theek hai? Then also it is going to provide a globally competitive incentive package to our domestic local companies involved in semiconductors and display manufacturing and its design, right? So that is going to be a win-win situation both for the market and for the consumers, and certainly for the government, which will get its import bill reduced, its reliance reduced on the foreign players or the foreign companies, especially the ones which are operating from China, right? Okay, so let's take the question now. Hanji, which of the following statements is or are correct with respect to design linked incentive scheme? First, the National Informatics Center will act as the nodal agency for the implementation of the DLI scheme, and second, under it domestic companies, startups, MSMEs will receive fiscal and design infrastructure support from the government over the next 5 years. So what do you think should be the answer here? ओके आहाना सेज बी राइट ठीक है ग्रेट. सो सर्टनली ओवर द नेक्स्ट 5 ईयर्स अगले 5 साल तक जो है ये सपोर्ट देने की बात की है गवर्नमेंट ने दैट इज एब्सोल्युटली फाइन बट दिस इज इफ यू आर सेइंग दैट दिस इज नॉट द नोडल सेंटर इफ नॉट द नेशनल इन्फॉर्मेटिक्स सेंटर देन वॉट इज गोइंग टू बी द नोडल एजेंसी. फर्स्ट स्टेटमेंट में एनआईसी की जगह क्या होना चाहिए था अगर इस स्टेटमेंट को आप लोग कह रहे हो कि ये गलत है देन फॉर दिस स्टेटमेंट टू बी ट्रू एग्जैक्टली द सेंटर फॉर डेवलपमेंट एंड एडवांस कंप्यूटिंग दैट इज सीडैक दैट इज गोइंग टू बी द नोडल एजेंसी. तो फर्स्ट जो है वो इनकरेक्ट हो जाएगा आपका आंसर हो जाएगा बी. ठीक है यस सेंटर फॉर डेवलपमेंट ऑफ एडवांस कंप्यूटिंग एग्जैक्टली एग्जैक्टली प्रांजल एंड आहाना दैट इज द केस के जो नोडल एजेंसी है दैट इज द सीडैक राइट एंड नॉट नेशनल इन्फॉर्मेटिक्स सेंटर. और इसमें याद रखना 5 ईयर्स के लिए सपोर्ट है दैट इज नॉट फॉर द करंट फाइनेंशियल और द नेक्स्ट फाइनेंशियल ईयर और नॉट फॉर 10, 20, 15 ईयर्स राइट. सो दैट कैन बी अ क्वेश्चन पोटेंशियली बाय द यूपीएससी. चलिए मूविंग टू द लास्ट क्वेश्चन फॉर द डे दैट इज विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट्स इज दर आर करेक्ट रिगार्डिंग कॉलर वाली दैट इज इट इज द नेम ऑफ द फर्स्ट एवर टाइगर्स टू बी कॉलर्ड एट पेंच टाइगर रिजर्व. सेकेंड द पेंच टाइगर रिजर्व इज सिचुएटेड इन द स्टेट ऑफ उड़ीसा. थर्ड कॉलर वैली हेल्ड द डिस्टिंग्विश्ड रिकॉर्ड ऑफ गिविंग बर्थ टू 5 cubs इन अ लिटर. यस हाँ एग्जैक्टली रोहित भारद्वाज सीडैक बिल्कुल. चलिए लेट्स कम टू द फिफ्थ क्वेश्चन. ओके रोहित इज सेइंग सी. हाँ जी बाकी लोग राहुल विवेक और ऑल्सो सेइंग सी. शुभंकर सेज सी एंड रेस्ट ऑफ यू महबूब सेज बी. सुरभि ऑल्सो सेज सी. ठीक है ग्रेट. सो लुक एज फार एज दिस यू नो आर्टिकल इज कंसर्न्ड सो दिस आर्टिकल वॉज कंसर्निंग कॉलर वाली विच वॉज द टाइग्रेस दैट वॉज attached with this collar right which was tagged in the Pench tiger reserve and it was the first tigress to be collared or to be tagged in the Pench tiger reserve which recently just died right and that is why it was in news. So the first statement is correct, the second statement is also correct, but the point is where is the Pench tiger reserve located? The Pench tiger reserve is, you know, it falls in two states, that is Maharashtra and Madhya Pradesh. Right, more is concerned with Madhya Pradesh, but that also shares with Maharashtra. So question 5 answer will be just 1 and 3, that is option B. But let's quickly take a look at the map. Right, here you can see that the Pench Tiger Reserve is marked here, 4 number, but it will not be visible in this map very clearly. Right, in the center you have the 4 number, but the point is that this is where you can see more clearly that is the Pench in Madhya Pradesh which is also sharing boundaries with the state of Maharashtra right. And why was it in news? Because right recently the Pench tiger reserve in the states of Madhya Pradesh predominantly and also in Maharashtra the reference was to the tiger in the reserve, that is it was also called as super momed and it was tracked through this tag which was attached to it. और ये नाम जो है ना कॉलर वाली ये इसी से ही है कि इट वॉज अटैच लाइक यू कैन अटैच दिस माइक ऑन द ऑन माई कॉलर और ऑन समबडीज कॉलर राइट. सो दैट इज वेयर द नेम कम्स फ्रॉम दैट इज द कॉलर वाली टाइग्रेस ऑल्सो नोन एज द क्वीन ऑफ द पेंच एंड अ सुपर मॉम हु बर्थ 29 cubs राइट एंड शी ऑल्सो हैड द डिस्टिंक्शन ऑफ गिविंग बर्थ टू 5 cubs इन वन गो इन वन सीक्वेंस. सो दैट इज यू नो अ रेयर situation where 5 cubs in a row are given birth to by a tigress right. So that is, you can zoom in that map and take a look at the Pench tiger reserve in the state of Maharashtra and this is the zoomed in map right. So with that we have come to an end and that's a quote from Plato to end the session that never discourage anyone who continually makes progress no matter how slow. So keep on treading on that path of progress, be it a slow progress but still that is counted for right in your overall success. So on that count, it's a wrap. Thank you so much for being actively involved with me in this session, and do hit that like button before you leave, right? Thank you so much. Jai Hind, and I'll see you tomorrow.